Hey you guys, welcome to my first video. I'm actually doing a review on Q Redew. As you can see, I'm actually putting the Q Redew through my hair to detangle it. My hair is pretty, I don't like to call my hair nappy, but it's tangled, you know. This is actually a four day old twist out, and I'm actually refreshing it. So yeah. Hey you guys, so what I'm gonna do to style my hair, I'm gonna moisturize my hair with Blue Magic. I'm thinking about moisturizing with the Shea Moisture with the conditioner only because I use the shampoo and I like to use the same products on like the wash weeks or whatever. And what I'm gonna use to twist my hair is this. This works so freaking good on my hair, like I love it. Then I'm gonna use my favorite detangling comb that I got from Walmart for like $7, not $19.99, not $20, $7. Let's get started. Alright you guys, so right now I'm going in with the Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil Leave-In Conditioner. I absolutely love this conditioner. I've actually been using it since I first started being natural. I'm going in with the peppermint oil. I usually use it on my wash days only, but you know, I have dry scalp. Sometimes it does help, you know, kind of relieve that itch that I would get. If y'all do have like any remedies for dry scalp, please drop it in the comments below to, you know, help a girl out. Alright, so now I'm going in with my Cantu scalp treatment, which actually really helped my dry scalp for the past week. And I've actually been sleeping on this product, and I think I'm going to start using it a little bit more. I actually do still use Blue Magic. It actually really helps moisturize my hair, keeps it moisturized. I also use it on my scalp as well. I actually go through my scalp and I moisturize it. And for the naturals who are trying to maintain your hair, I do recommend using pure grapeseed oil, and I do mix it in with the 5 treatment oil from Cream of Nature.
And just make it a part. So I moisturize my hair. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead, take this Q Redew out the plug, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna separate this. I'm gonna put it in some clips. Always keep like an extra clip just in case I need to like clip some of this away. Alright y'all, so I'm gonna go in with my, I believe it's pronounced Maui. Excuse me, I'm in college. Y'all, I know I'm probably supposed to know how to this, but yeah. I usually don't use a comb. I'm just being a little extra for the video, but I'm gonna go with my lovely brush. I love this brush. Let me show y'all my favorite, my used to be favorite comb. It's not even in the drawer. That's how you know I don't had a major affair with that comb, with this brush. Whew. That comb is nowhere to be found.
Alright you guys, so right here I'm just going in. I'm really just showing y'all really the twist out process. My favorite twist out is actually 2-strand twist. I did hear that three strand twists were pretty good, but honestly I don't know how to do it. I'm gonna learn, you know, as I keep making more videos, but this is the process of how I did like a chunky type twist out. My hair is not that long, but it is getting way longer than what it was when I first cut it. I may leave a video or maybe even make an introductory video about my hair journey, but this is an example of a t-strand twist.
Okay guys, so this is the finished slash unfinished look. These are how my chunky twists came out. That's why I love to use like Q Redew, because you can like really get like, look, look at that. Oh, and this is how much hair I lost with the brush. And to remind y'all, well, I never told y'all, but I'm refreshing my hair from a 3-day twist out. So this is actually pretty good. You got them juicy curves. Them juicy. It's getting a little hot.
The next day.
Okay, you guys, so this is the final look.
All right, you guys, so this is the final look. I hope that you like and subscribe, and hopefully I see you in my next video. Bye.